In my second year at the university, during the second semester, I sat in a sociology class, and I was listening to this visiting professor from the University of Wisconsin in the United States. And during his lecture, he said something very profound, which he doesn't normally do. I mean, he will come to class and then lecture throughout. But then in the course of his lecture, he just stopped and then said this. The kind of educational system we used to have, referring to the US, is what you people are still using. What is the normal response of a student if he hears that? Laughter. We all laughed. But then I went back to my hostel and then it pricked my mind. I was like, hold on. What is he trying to say? This is the point he was trying to make. What we know as students has not been updated for a very long time. And he tried to say it in a very nice way. What we know as young people and as students has not been updated for a very long time, and that's the status we are living in. So for me, I got curious. I just wanted to update my knowledge by any means. I took so much risk, even as a student in UCC. I would skip lectures. Please don't do that. I would skip lectures and then attend events, thought-provoking events in Accra, in Kumasi, in Tamale, anywhere. And my friends would be like, are you aware your grade is going down? I'm like, yes, but I don't know why I am traveling. Because I wanted to update my knowledge. I just didn't want to be normal. And in my quest to find an opportunity to update my knowledge, I chanced upon a youth-powered event called Barcamp Ghana. You can see that it's a bar plus camp equals Barcamp. That makes me a UCC student, you know, because we are very theoretical. But anyway, the Barcamp is not a beer bar. So just relax. Barcamp is an initiative by the GhanaThink Foundation, and its aim is to build a network of young people who are change makers, doers, and entrepreneurs. That is all about Barcamp. What we are trying to do is to create a forum for young people to come and learn, share, connect, and then also receive mentorship. This is an event where I attended in 2012 and then realized that a lot of young people are taking advantage of social media to create opportunities for themselves and others. I was like, what in the world is happening here? I have never seen this before. And I was moved. This is a forum where, I mean, a whole lot of people come together, young people, a lot of them, they come together and share ideas. Barcamp so far has organized over 59 events, trained and updated the knowledge of 8,000 young people across the nation since its inception in 2008. One of the significant things that I'm happy about any time I attend events, especially Barcamp that we organize, is when somebody comes to me and says, Kofi, if not for this event, I wouldn't have known ABC. For me, that is fulfilling. It's enough for me. Let me run you through some of the significant impact that Barcamp has made. One of the things Barcamp has made, achieved so far, is what we call the Blogging Ghana Association, if you have heard of it. How many of us have heard of Blogging Ghana Association? Blogging Ghana Association simply brings together bloggers to connect and share. And this idea emerged out of our breakout session during Barcamp event. The other picture you see there is a group of young girls trying to learn how to code. And it's an initiative called the Tech Needs Girls Initiative. They teach young girls how to code. And they've received lots of assistance and lots of funding and lots of opportunities to train young girls. And guess what? This idea emerged out of Barcamp. The other one you see is called Kasahoro. It's an app. It's a simple thing. You just install it on your mobile device, and then you can translate. In fact, type in your own local language, be it Ewe, be it Chi, Hausa, or whatsoever. And they've been able to translate books and sold over 10,000 of them over Amazon. They're right here in Ghana, anyway. See, why am I sharing with you all these impact stories? Every impact I shared with you largely happened because of the power of social media. This is why, as young people, we need to leverage on this new media to create a social revolution of sharing vital quality and updated information. You know what? You cannot innovate in this world or contribute to the growth of your country if you do not know where the world is shifting to. You agree? Also, we cannot expect progress as individuals and as nations if our minds are filled with outdated knowledge. It's impossible. It will never happen. You can't progress. We can't also continue to give excuses as young people and as Africans. Why? Because updated knowledge is right in our hands through the connected mobile phones we have. So there are no excuses anymore. It's at a click. You agree? Yeah. So let us take advantage of this social media as we visit these social media platforms and update our own knowledge to create a social movement of knowledge sharing. That is all. Invest time, invest resources in updating your own knowledge. In fact, my being here on this stage is as a result of social media, nothing else. And most of you who know me will agree. Let us come together as young people. Ask yourself, if I visit this ABC social media, what am I doing there? Why am I spending time there? What is the end result of what I'm doing? We are in a revolution, which is called the fourth revolution. We had the industrial revolution. We are in the fourth revolution, which is the digital revolution. And as fast as you can, you better grab it, or it's too late. Thank you.